Right guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to another video. In this one I'm just going to be showing you how to fit your Shimano R8000 rim brake calipers to your bike. So let's go ahead, let's run through the steps.
Right, so here we have the R8000 caliper. So I'll just point a few things out before we actually fit it. So you've got your mounting bolt there on the back, that's a 5mm. Then you've got a 4mm there for your cable pinch bolt. Obviously you've got your lever there to open your caliper up to drop your wheel out of your frame, and then you've got your barrel adjuster up here, and that is a 2mm hex there just for your fine adjustment there. So if you say you bought them, your calipers second hand for instance, before you fit them just make sure that the 2mm on the side there, as you can see, is just sticking out. If you can see that, it's just sticking out like that, proud of the body slightly. Before you go ahead and fit it, that's how they are when they're new. So make sure yours is set like that, because it could be screwed all the way in, and then you won't have the range of adjustment when you need it. So make sure it's set like that when your pads are new and you're gonna fit it, just in case yours is different to that on the setting. So we go ahead, we'll get these fitted. So what we do is we just put the caliper in through the fork like that, and then obviously with your nut on the other side, make sure your nut's long enough to actually meet the threads of the caliper. So what you want to do is just tighten it up until the caliper is just done up enough so the caliper can just move like that, side to side to start with. Don't need to worry about tightening right up at the moment. As long as the caliper, you can move the caliper just about left to right. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and get the wheel back in. So here we are on the shift lever end. So if you put your outer cable in there, obviously it doesn't have any stop on the end, it just goes straight in. The cable just goes straight in the outer cable like that. So you get that in there and push it all the way in until it stops. And then on these ones, because this is external rooted cable, just to hold the cable temporarily in position while you're sizing it up, what I've got is just a little cable tie around there like that. So it goes through the cable tie, so it's just holding itself in position just to size up the outer cable. So obviously on the outer, on the front, so this is in the UK, so the front brake is on the right. So what we do is we got it like that, so easy to size it up. When you steer, it has no effect on it because it's the front. Now when it's the rear, the outer cable, make sure that you steer left to right fully round to make sure that you've got enough length of cable before it goes into your frame. So when you steer in, it doesn't interfere with anything, it's not impeding the steering at all. But like I say, the front, it doesn't matter. You just put it in like that, as long as it's cut to the right length. You snip that off like that, and it's not interfering with anything to do with the steering. The brake outer on the front, but it is on the rear, so we just snip that down to length and clean the end up. Then that goes straight into the barrel adjuster as it is with no end on it. So before you put your outer cable into your barrel adjuster there, if you cut this, make sure that you've cleaned the end off of any jagged bits of metal sticking out, and open the end up with something pointed as well up inside the housing before you put it in there. Now you need a good pair of cutters, or if you've got a grinder or a little multi-tool, you can clean it up with the end of that and then put it in. Just makes for a better breaking if you haven't got any jagged bits metal sticking out of the end before you put it in there. You want it nice and flush on the end. So when it comes to putting your outer cable in, what you want to do is depress the lever, brake lever like that, and you'll see where it goes in that hole. just there. So you put it in that hole, just leave it depressed like that while you're sliding it on through, and it should go straight through and then into your outer cable. And then just make sure that the end is all the way in, which I'll show you in a sec. So we've got the cable in there, as you can see, the stop is up in the end properly. Then you can just let go the lever and pull on. When you let go, just make sure you pull on the other end to make sure that's not coming out of there at all. Just give it a pull on the cable, seat it properly, so it's all the way in. Then we can move on back to the caliper again. So, being as we haven't done the caliper up fully yet, or torqued it up or anything, the reason for that is, now the caliper's on there and it moves, like I said, it can move it left and right. So what we've done is position the pads so as they're obviously making contact with the braking surface, as they roughly at the minute, we haven't set them up properly yet, we just made them so they're in line with the rim. So when you clamp up the brake like that, you can see that side's touching the rim and this side isn't yet. So what we want to do is, to get it centralised, you can move that over. So like I said, this side's touching, this side isn't. So what we'll do is get on the caliper body and just move it over slightly, and then do it again. Make sure they're both touching the rim at roughly the same time. So we just get it centralised as best we can, like that, so they're both contacting at the same time. And then when they are, what you want to do then is just make sure, just hold the brake on, and then just nip up your 5mm hex head so it's tight. So just tighten that up like that. We torque it up when we finished. Now we just nip it up tight so the caliper's not moving and the pads are contacting at the same time. Just check it again, make sure they are. If not, just readjust it. So now we've got it, the caliper centralised on the wheel as best we can. What you want to do is obviously line up your brake pads however you prefer them. So when you obviously clamp it up like that, you can see exactly where they're going to impact the rim, so make sure they're in the right place, obviously central on the braking surface, not too high or not too low on there. They're going in the middle and they're level at the front and the back with the braking surface. Now, so that's a 4mm hex head on the outside there, just undo that. So if you slacken it off just enough so the pad will move, so if you let it off, obviously the pad moves like that. So when you clamp it up, you can just line it up with the middle like that, then hold the brake on with your hands and get it exactly right, so as when you brake, it's touching all the way along at the same time, and then just nip it up. Now, some people prefer a little bit of toe on the pad, so the back of the pad, so the front is contacting first before the back, so to speak. Now, if you want to achieve that, all you've got to do is get a small elastic band like that, just tie a knot in it, as you see, with a loop. So all you do is get that loop, and I'll show you on the front of the pad, but you want to put it on the back there. So you just clip it over like that, and effectively the band will just be sitting on the braking surface there, so it'll keep it away as you're holding the brake on and nipping it up. Obviously it's keeping that away, and then when you let go of the brake, you can just take the band off. So you just put it over the back of the pad like that, in position, and leave it on there. Make sure it's on the actual surface, not in one of the grooves or anything. So just leave it sat there like that while you're doing the adjustment. And then when you let go, just take that band off, and it should just give you a little bit of toe. You only want like 0.5mm of toe on it, so the back here, 0.5mm away from the rim, if you prefer the toe on the pad. So we're happy with the pad alignment. Now what we've done is we just put the cable behind the pinch bolt. For now, it's not done up, it's still loose. Obviously make sure that your lever for your caliper here is done up. Now, what you want to do, before we do up the pinch bolt, so say it's still loose, the cable still moves freely behind it, is go up to your barrel adjuster and just wind that anti-clockwise about 3 or 4 turns, just wind it up first. And then what you want to do after you've done that is squeeze the pads against the rim like that. And then when you've done that, make sure that the cable's in there properly. And then snug up your cable and just pinch it up like that. Now, look, you'll see the pads are tight against the rim, so it just moves. Then what you want to do then is go to your barrel adjuster and wind it back down like that. Now you'll see that it moves the pads away from the rim. So the gap when you brake should be roughly right, however you prefer yours to be set up. Because if you want them a bit closer to the rim, then you can just wind up your barrel adjuster slightly. If you want them very close to the rim, just wind it up a couple of turns, and obviously you tighten the gap up and make the brakes however you want them, however you prefer the feel. But being like that is beneficial, because obviously when your pads are wearing out, you can go to your barrel adjuster and it's wound all the way down, so you've got the whole thread sticking down here. So when you wind it anti-clockwise as your pads wear, you can tweak it anti-clockwise to counter the difference of the pads wearing over time. And then when you want to put new pads in when they're worn, you just wind the barrel adjuster all the way back down, then you can put new pads in. So before we snip the cable to length and put a stop on it, what you can do now is just, when you're happy with that, you just go ahead, I've seen torque your caliper up, make sure it's tight enough, that's about 7-8 newton meters on that, torque it up, and then double check, obviously make sure your pinch bolt's tight and your pads as well. And then we're ready, just go ahead and snip the cable down and put a stop on it. I'm just crimp on a stop on the end of the cable there. So when you brake, what you're looking for is both of the pads touching at the same time. Now obviously what we've done is centralise the caliper as best we could. So effectively they should be almost touching at the same time. Now if you look closely at the wheel when you're doing it, the rim, you want it so they're both touching, so the wheel rim isn't getting pushed one way slightly or the other way. They're both contacting at the same time. So what that 2 millimeter does on the side there is when you move that, so what it does by screwing it in, if you're doing it clockwise, it's moving the pad here, the arm, it's moving that, so clockwise is moving the arm closer to the rim this side, and anti-clockwise moves this pad further away from the rim. So you can just adjust it as well, just a fine adjustment there on that. So when you just brake slowly, just make sure they're both, and look at both pads, make sure they're both contacting at the same time and it's not pushing the rim over or anything. If it is, you can just tweak it with the 2 millimeter just to get it absolutely spot on.
So So if you found the video helpful, remember to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel for more cycle-related content. Till next one, ride safe, and I'll see you then.